Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today I'm going to do something a little bit different. I call it echo blending, and it's a technique created using multiple layers of the same video and blending modes. So let's get started. First of all, we have got this clip. It's 12 seconds long, give or take a frame, of some kung fu fighting action. And what we first want to do is be able to duplicate the clip, and we'll take the second clip and we'll move it along three frames. We'll go back to our first clip, and then from there we're going to go into frame and fit, go down to blending and change the blending mode to lighten. After that, we'll repeat the same process for the duplicate layer, back into frame and fit, change the blending to lighten, and then you'll start to see the effect build up. So we've got two punches going on. So we duplicate the layer again, move it three frames, and then you'll start to see the echo effect really taking place. We've now got three punches, and then a further time, duplicate once again, and this time we're going to stretch it to four, so the last one drags a little bit. There we go. If we play that through, you'll see you get this echo, delay, whatever you want to call it, fight effect, and then it snaps back to the ending. Now what I want to do is hold on that ending a little bit. So I'm going to generate a snapshot, drag it down to the main timeline, and then that way we can just hold on the end somewhat. Then what we want to do is render the current layer out. So to render it out, we tap on our share export icon, go to movie, and then choose the rendered movies folder within LumaFusion. The original video was a 1080, we'll just keep to that, increase the quality to 30 megabits per second, and then we'll render that out, takes a few seconds. And then what we can do is delete the original layer whilst keeping the snapshot, and now we're working with a single layer with the effect applied. And that's looking pretty good. Now to finish things off, we will grade the footage. So I'm going to go into pencil and then into our color and effects. And I think the coolant preset is a good starting point. Now, I don't know whether I want to take the color away or add it in a bit more. I think we'll strengthen it somewhat. Add a little bit more blue, play with the gamut a little bit. Just darken it down slightly. And then up the contrast. And what we want to do is just play with the whites at the far end, the point where they're almost clipping. That looks pretty good. Just play it through. Quite happy with that. And what we'll then do is go to our linked folders and then media. And I should have audio assets. And we go to media and then tucked away in the actual tutorial assets for echo blending, which is here. I should have the audio that I'm looking for, which is this one here. And I did this sound design separately. That looks pretty good. And then the other thing I want to add in is just a heartbeat that I've called Kung Fu Heartbeat. And then we'll just trim the back end up. See if it goes to there. Trim everything away. And then that leaves us with snapshot, which we can copy the effects and then paste the attributes in. We only need the color, paste that, and we'll go back to the beginning, play it through. As you can see, it's quite an interesting little effect. Now, I chose the blending mode lighten. If we just go back into frame and fit a little second, by all means, experiment with different blending modes. So for example, try one of the stencil or silhouette effects, or even difference or explosion, just to see what kind of effect you can get for yourself. Again, using the moving three frames for each duplicate layer. And that way you can customize the effect. I like this one. And there we go, just a simple, quick, easy tutorial on how to use the blending mode and a little bit of time dilation, frame shifting, timey-wimey to create this ghostly echo effect for your video. If you've enjoyed the video tutorial today, by all means, give the video a like. If I've earned your subscription, once again, subscribe to the channel and don't forget to ring the bell to be notified of any future video tutorials. And I will catch you on the next one. See you later.